Hey guys, this is about the Five Force Analysis. Now, to celebrate talking about the Five Force Analysis, I'm here in Vicenza, Italy. This is Palladian's Basilica, a very famous building from a very famous architect, designer, whatever you want to call it. Anyway, so, Five Force Analysis is an industry-wide analysis. You know, you look at the industry as a whole. There's five things you're going to look at. One, you look at the potential threat of new entrants. How possible is it that a new company can come in to our industry? And if it's not very likely, well, you don't worry too much about it. But what you look at, is there a high cost to get into the industry? So like the car industry is very expensive to get in, so it's very unlikely that people are going to join up. There's not going to be, you know, I don't see new car companies coming all the time. So very unlikely that anyone's going to come and join in that. However, if you look at in restaurant industry, there's not much to stop you. You know, if you can cook, you can start a restaurant, so that's an industry that's very easy to come in. Okay, then you're going to look at the bargaining power of suppliers. Okay, how powerful are the people that get me my products? You know, if I'm a restaurant, how powerful are the Coca-Colas versus the people that get me the meat? Now, meat you can get from pretty much anybody, but you know that your customers have to have Coca-Cola when they drink, when they eat. So, you know that, okay, Coke has some more power over me than the local grocer or the local butcher. Okay. Then you look at your bargaining power, your customers. How important are your customers? Okay. Do you have one big customer? Because if you have one big customer that has most of your business, well, they're going to have a lot more power over you. Okay. If you only sell to Walmart, they say, no, we want lower prices, you're pretty much screwed. You're going to have to do what they want. Okay. But if you have lots of different customers, well, you don't really care. That's why when you go to stores and restaurants and tourist areas, they're really bad to the customers because they know the next day there's going to be new tourists and new people because the customers don't have very much power over them. Okay? Then you have the threat of substitutes. How likely is it a customer will switch from using your product to a similar product? So this is how worried are the car companies worried that you're going to switch and start taking the Metro? Okay? Not very likely because people love their cars. Now, what else? Then you look at the final part, which is rivalry. How do the companies compete? You know, if you look at the key success factors, okay, they looked at how, sorry, it's a chocolate festival right now, so I gotta have that too. So if you look at the rivalry of the customers, or between the competitors, I mean, is it Coke and Pepsi where they fight over everything? Or is there plenty of space in the market where everyone can grow? So you don't see too many people fighting, so people can focus in different areas. Okay? That's a basic breakdown of the Five Force Analysis here in Vicenza, Italy. You know, I love you guys, but chocolate's so good. It's so good.